I have the sad task of confirming the death of Sergeant Gallagher. We have located his remains in the rubble of his residence in Port-au-Prince. This is devastating news for Mark's family and for all of us.
Everything was just falling apart, you know, all over the place. You know, people was crying and, you know, the roof, like the ceiling was falling and there was no place to hide.
Giving, and he's been a role model for us, and he'll always be our hero. Mark's last trip home this Christmas was different. Mark was conflicted on a number of different levels. He had tremendous trouble reconciling our lifestyle to the misery he was seeing in Haiti.
Seeing first on is a bit of a shock. It sets you back. The real people that are having, you know, a very difficult time. The conditions of the poverty here. I mean, it's the third poorest country in the world, and it certainly is evident.
He had been dreaming for years about giving back, and so this mission to Haiti wasn't about work. It was more a spiritual journey for Mark. And he wanted, and he kept saying if he could just make a difference in the life of even one child there, that he would.
The Friends of Mark Gallagher Project is a partnership between the Friends of Mark Gallagher and the sisters in Riviere Froide. They're a community made up of 250 members of religious sisters. And they've been serving the rural poor in Haiti since 1948. For over 60 years. Their mission is to assist the poor with education, health care, and assisting them with sustaining their lives in any way possible. One of their schools in Riviere Froide was destroyed in the earthquake on January the 12th. In this one school alone in Riviere Froide, 100 students, two lay teachers, and four of the sisters lost their lives. This project is focused on building the vocational school that the sisters had planned on building before this devastating earthquake. A vocational school means that these young people would be able to attain employment, develop skills and trades that will assist them economically as well as developing their local communities. A priest mentor of mine, now deceased, often commented on our capacity as human beings to love and assist others. He would often say something like this: "We cannot do everything, but we can do something. And it's essential that we do something." This project is one response to this huge disaster, and it is inspired by Sergeant Mark Gallagher, who seemed to always find a way to do his something to assist others in his life.
Mark Gallagher touched many lives. His impact was felt in many communities here in New Brunswick and in Haiti, where he worked to make life better for all who knew him.
Mark touched the hearts of everyone he met.
And that's the kind of guy he was.
Caring for people was how he lived, and everyone was important.
Mark was passionate about helping people in need. His legacy lives on with this gold project, where the need remains great. As the people of Haiti continue to rebuild and recover, the committee formed around this gold project is committed to seeing this project through, to improve the welfare of children in Riviere Froide, Haiti. I am delighted to lend my name and support to this noble project, helping those less fortunate children in Haiti and lending to the outstanding legacy of Mark Gallagher.
If you are seeking a concrete way to do your something in assisting our brothers and sisters in Haiti, this is a project that you might want to learn more about.
If this is one little way that we can be part of it, then I want to be part of it.